Spring breeding season is a really important time for getting out to get any kind of observations on abundance with spotted frogs, because the best way to actually count abundance by looking at egg masses. So in the spring, they start to come out of their overwintering areas and move into the shallows of these wetland habitats. The males start calling. The calling is a very low knocking sound, kind of like a distant woodpecker. They'll find some nice warm place in the wetland and deposit the egg masses. They're communal breeders, so they will come as a group together to lay these egg masses. Oregon spotted frogs' historic range was from British Columbia down to the Pitt River drainage in California. So they covered most of the Pacific Northwest. Back in the early 90s, some researchers were finding that they had disappeared from a good portion of their range. Here in the Deschutes Basin in the central Cascades is kind of the hot spot for Oregon spotted frogs.
Oh, there's an egg mass.
We have the largest, number of populations, and in some cases, some of the higher abundances that are remaining in the range.
Oh, and there's another pair right there. So I see one pair, two pair.
And this area represents 53% of the critical habitat range-wide. It takes a lot of people to survey over this large geographic area. We all team up and I try to coordinate on where we're going and when. Once it happens, it can happen all at once and then it's over. Not only are they communal breeders, but they have a strong fidelity to these oviposition sites or these breeding places that they like to go. So you kind of know where you might find them, which is really always sort of fun and, you know, it's exciting. Where are those breeding sites or the oviposition sites? How do those move over the years? The Oregon spotted frog is probably the most aquatic frog in the Pacific Northwest. It spends its entire life cycle in the water. So where other frogs will be in the water for just a portion of their life cycle, the Oregon spotted frog remains in the water as adults. So it's important that you have water in places year-round for spotted frogs. Here in the Deschutes Basin, we have spotted frogs up in the wilderness, lakes and ponds that drain into the Little Deschutes system and the Deschutes system. And then their distribution is as far downstream as Bend, Oregon. And then we've got them in both reservoirs here on the Deschutes. And in particular, the wetland habitats that are downstream of Wickiup Dam are dependent upon, you know, flow releases from the dam.
Under historical conditions, the Deschutes River is a groundwater-fed system. And so the flow from season to season, year to year, was fairly steady. Over the last century, as this area has grown, there's been a higher need for water on this landscape. And, you know, the agriculture that this river feeds is fairly important. And so it's a system now that delivers water for agriculture. We store water in the upper watershed in the wintertime, and that causes flows in the river to come down. In the summertime, when people are growing food, we send water down the river and it comes up. But as that hydrology changes, the habitat for these animals also changes. The timing, when and where water is on this landscape, it matters. What we're really trying to get a handle on is the relationship of river flows to some of these key habitats. You know, this is water in the West, and it's complicated. People really rely on it. And so any solution that is going to be found for flows and habitat in this river is really going to require the input of a lot of different entities. Municipalities, irrigation districts, conservation organizations, federal agencies, state agencies, tribes. It has to be a group effort because the reliance on water in this basin is for livelihoods. We have changed a few things with how water is released out of Wickiup Reservoir right now. We've picked up base flows in the wintertime a bit. We've also worked with some shaping flows to get water higher during the critical period of breeding in the spring that puts water into certain pieces of habitat while still providing water to farmers and sustaining rivers. Having the frog be the focus for conservation has really changed the way that we're talking about water in this basin. It has drawn the attention away of not just keeping water in the channel, but putting it out on the floodplain and putting it back into the wetlands.
If we are improving our wetland ecosystems and maintaining habitat, you know, connectivity, we're going to be improving habitat for fish and other wildlife and improving the function of the riverine and wetland ecosystems. Our watersheds are going to be a lot more functional, and we all benefit from that.
Every river needs its mascot, and so I think this one might be the Oregon spotted frog.